Well, time point is going to be, this is one of the newest restaurants here, West Bridgewater, Niko's Pizza. The food is delicious, the service is great. This is just part of our efforts to promote local businesses and business owners. And the people in the community more involved with the local products. They're part of the tour up here today, so. When it's plenty of pizza and we're all cheese there, so.
I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do that. What are your thoughts on that?
I don't think it's so much bridging the gap, but it's shifting the burden is what it is. How many years have we seen this? The federal government cuts back the monies they allocate to the states, and the states now are going to cut back and give the states and towns. And ultimately, and I can see this as well, the buck stops at the moment. And then we simply pass that on to the homeowner resident taxpayer who will prop to a halfway ride or a higher levy of 2.5%. I don't think that's the answer. We've got to find ways to grow revenue within the pump. You know, just simply taxing and passing the tax burden down the chain doesn't make sense to me. We should be attracting more industry, higher tech and healthcare, fast-growing industries. All of those jobs should be here in Massachusetts. I go to the southeastern Massachusetts. That's one place we can start. Education. We really don't have an exceptional story about the entire state. I think the city of Brockton could use a higher educational institution. Those are the fast rolling fields, and that's something that happens. Wouldn't necessarily say I'm against it, but I don't think it should be the huge
problem.
And I think more can be done internally to manage some of this administration. I don't believe everyone is right to be able to see about driving a car. I just don't think that's the case. I don't see the data supporting it. At the same time, we've added this profit component to health insurance, which we want. I think what we're seeing as a result of all the higher end costs. Charlie Baker, I'm very fortunate to have been a CEO of an HO, making over $1 million to sell. Yes, obviously the rainy years are the ones that pay for this. So again, if we take some of that profit-driven incentive out, you will see some success. If you take Medicare, for instance, I know there's 3 cents on every dollar spent for these treatment services. On private insurance, there's a 3 cents per dollar as allocation. And that's used for advertising, inflated CEO salaries, and a whole host of other things. So, you know, we've always got to look internally at the entire system.
Sure,
37 years old, getting quickly towards 30 years old. I'm married to my wife, I think that's the culture. I think too many legislators are delegating the authority to leadership. And that's where we're getting
in the head out.
We need a little bit more independence from our legislators, taking those types of stances, and it's going to get the institution better as well. Well, I just want to thank WATD for coming down here tonight. Always glad to partner up with them in these types of endeavors. I certainly encourage our listeners to visit our website for questions or concerns at www.albany.com. I look forward to having your support. Thank you. You too. Good to see you.